In this illustration, we'll discuss about the elastic collision with an impact parameter. Here in the situation, you can see a small particle is moving at a speed v toward a spherical body of same mass at rest with an impact parameter c and collide elastically on its surface. We are going to find final velocities of both the bodies. So here, as collision is elastic, we can conserve energy as well as linear momentum in plane where the two bodies are colliding. Here again we can see that the body, spherical body, is placed on a smooth horizontal surface and we are looking at it from its top view. So if we draw the situation at the time of collision, if this is the spherical body, and from the body at an impact parameter c, the small particle collides. So when it is coming at a speed v and strikes the surface, at the point of collision, the normal reaction would be acting along the radial direction. And as this body was at rest, after collision it starts moving in this direction, say with the velocity v2. And due to this n, say this body moves tangentially. As we already discussed, if the bodies are of equal masses, they diverge at right angle. So if this angle is theta, from the line of motion, this angle will also be theta and this will be 90 minus theta. So we can conserve momentum along and perpendicular to radial direction, or you can say along tangential and radial direction. This angle will also be theta. As this impact parameter is c and the radius of ball is r, here we can write the value of sine theta is equals to c by r, and the value of cos theta will be root of 1 minus c square by r square. Now in this situation we can say, by conservation of linear momentum of bodies along radial and tangential direction, this gives, you can see, initial momentum along radial direction was mv cos theta, and finally the spherical body is moving with the speed v2, so we can write it as mv cos theta is equals to mv2, and along tangential direction we can write the momentum of a particle was mv sin theta and this equals to mv1. Now here m gets cancelled out, and from these relations, if these are equation 1 and equation 2, we can directly get the value of v2 is equals to v cos theta, which is v root of 1 minus c square by r square. And from equation 2, we directly get the value of v1, the velocity of particle after collision, this v sin theta. So this v multiplied by c by r. So these are the results of this problem, the velocities of both the bodies after collision.